The first basic fact is that the signal quality achievable with X-rays in imaging is a function of the dose. The more dose you apply, the better the image becomes. That is pretty much the same like in the interview we're doing right now. You have to have a decent light to get a good image. In X-rays, you have to have a certain dose to achieve the image quality you want, and that in turn should not be higher than the diagnostic task you're looking at. So the first fundamental relationship is you have dose and you have the signal quality, or engineers saying the signal to noise ratio. And that goes with a square root function. So to double the signal to noise ratio, you have to increase the dose by times 4. Then the other two terms people use to assess sensors is either the ability to detect objects like carriers, which to the engineer transforms into signal to noise ratio. So you have signal to noise ratio, you have the dose, and you have the ability to detect small details in the image. In dentistry, the most distinguished image you might want to look at is the tip of a file in a root canal treatment. The engineers typically assess that feature, the technical parameter, by looking at phantoms made out of lead, which have a pattern of strip and air called a line pair phantom. And you can either optimize your system to work best at small objects, meaning at line pair per millimeters, ratings which are high, or you can optimize the signal to noise ratio, or you can optimize the dose. The means to do this is first how you convert X-ray energies into the signal. The nowadays state-of-the-art digital sensors using a material called a scintillator to convert the X-ray image into a visible light signal, and that in turn is detected by the chip inside the sensor. Now the chip has pixels as pretty much as a cell phone camera or as a professional SLR camera. And pixels have many properties, and for our discussion the most important property is the size of the pixel, the surface of the pixel. If you make the pixel very small, you have a good ability to detect high line pairs per millimeter, but you sacrifice your signal to noise ratio. If you make the pixel large, you pay a price on the line pair per millimeters, but you gain on the signal to noise ratio. Now, the SUNY sensor, coming back to your original question, is using intentionally larger pixels than many other competing products. And there's one pretty easy reason for it. The line pair per millimeters on the phantom is one thing, but you have to consider the actual objects in your oral cavity. If the smallest object in your oral cavity can be detected at, let's say, 12 line pairs per millimeters, then the question is, do you really need to have a sensor which can detect 16 or 18 line pairs per millimeter? So, spinning back to your question, the SUNY design team for the SUNY Ray sensor decided to use intentionally larger pixels to gain headroom for optimizing the sensor for low dose imaging, while displaying all of the information part of the image from a dental cavity. I would not confirm to the term still a diagnostic image. It's just the scientific dental community uses and teaches a concept called ALARA, as low as reasonable achievable. And the SUNY working point is to use pixels slightly larger than current sensors from competition, but smaller, like the pixels of sensors used in the 90s as digital imaging was established. As digital imaging was established, the first sensors had pixel dimensions suitable to display around 9 to 10 line pairs per millimeter under dental viewing conditions. So the playing question is, do we need to go further? Do we need to go to 16, 18 line pairs per millimeter? Or do we stop at a chosen value and start to optimizing for low dose performance? And this only decision was to stop at a certain line per millimeter performance and to trim the system for the other parameters.